मान्यश्री शासन सभापति मान्यश्री शासन मंडली अध्यक्षुलु गौरव शासन सभ्युलु गौरव शासन मंडली सभ्युलु अंदरिकी ना शुभाभिवंदनमुलु तेलंगाणा राष्ट्र उभय सभलनु उद्देशिंची प्रसंगिस्तुन्नंदुकु नाकु एंतो आनंदंगा उंदी। ई समावेशानिकी మీ అందరికి సాదరంగా స్వాగతం పలుకుతున్నాను। మీ అందరికి నా శుభాకాంక్షలు। ఈ రోజు చారిత్రాత్మకంగా ఒక శుభ దినం। ఇట్ ఇస్ ఇండీడ్ ఎ మొమెంటస్ అకేషన్ టుడే యాజ్ ఇట్ మార్క్స్ ద రియలైజేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద డ్రీమ్స్ ఆఫ్ క్రోర్స్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణైట్స్ హూ మేడ్ రిలెంట్లెస్ ఎఫర్ట్స్ అండ్ అజిటేషన్స్ over several decades. At the same time, my government cannot forget the sacrifices of hundreds of youngsters who played a key role in the last 1.5 decade long movement for achieving statehood for Telangana. They loved their Telangana so much that they did not bother about their career, studies, and even sentiments of their parents. For them, the driving force was only a belief that crores of fellow Telanganites would have a bright future with a little sacrifice of career and even lives. No one can measure the value of the sacrifices of these sons and daughters of the soil. Keeping in mind their sacrifice for the cause of Telangana, my government is determined to extend rupees 10 lakhs as monetary assistance to each of the bereaved families. Besides, government job will be provided to one eligible person in each such family. Cultivable land would be provided in case the family is involved in farming, apart from housing to the needy, along with free education and health care to their family. My government believes that graft, particularly political corruption, is the bane of our polity and economy. Unless it is eradicated, the fruits of progress cannot be enjoyed by one and all. Hence, my government is committed to root out political corruption at any cost. We are implementing a transparent strategy to eliminate graft at all levels. Considering the social structures in Telangana, my government is formulating several programs for the welfare of the people. Of course, development is a major goal for any state, but my government believes that development at the cost of welfare would have little meaning. We are conscious of the fact that lakhs of families are still living below the poverty line, and millions of children are not in a position to access good education. It is precisely for this reason that my government had decided to lay particular emphasis on the welfare of SCs, STs, BCs, minorities, and the poor among other sections of society by spending 1 lakh crore rupees in the coming 5 years. With reference to welfare of SCs, I must share with you all that expected results couldn't be derived from various SC welfare programs in the past. Hence, my government is now keen to see that the fruits of all those schemes are enjoyed by the deserving. In order to see that their eyes are filled with sparks of ecstasy, my government would allocate rupees 50,000 crores during the next 5 years. We will create a dedicated wing in the social welfare department which will implement the special component plan. We will ensure that not a single paisa is diverted from the funds meant for SC welfare schemes and that no pilferage is. Since tribals constitute a sizable proportion of the state's population, my government will provide up to 12% reservation in respect of education and government employment. We are also keen to confer SC status to Kaiti Lambadas and Valmiki Boyas. We are aware that there is demand from tribals of plain areas for sanctioning an ITDA for them. We shall examine this and take appropriate steps soon. Lambada, Tandas and Adivasi Gudams would be reconstituted as panchayats. As per the AP Reorganization Act, a tribal university will be established at the earliest in the state of Telangana. As BC welfare is equally important for my government, we have decided to take up a comprehensive development of BCs by spending rupees 25,000 crore over the next 5 years through a foolproof mechanism to improve the status of weavers who constitute a major chunk among the BCs. My government has decided to constitute an expert committee to study the conditions of toddy tappers, handloom weavers and all other artisans so that appropriate measures could be taken for their development. Telangana has seen a healthy integration of people belonging to different religions, languages and cultures. People have always lived here in harmony. Telangana is known for its Ganga Jamuna Tehzeeb. It is the responsibility of my government to take care of the interest in this direction. We are committed to provide up to 12% reservation to them. We are going to provide an unprecedented annual allocation of rupees 1,000 crores budget for the welfare of minorities. I am reminded of how Mahatma Gandhi praised the composite culture of Telangana, enriched by tolerance and harmony. In 1927, in his address at the VV College, Hyderabad, we will take appropriate steps for the preservation of Urdu language. Pension to the needy cannot be a meager amount, serving no purpose. All these years, we have claimed to provide pensions to the poor, though the quantum of the pension is most insufficient to make both ends meet. Now, as part of the welfare measures, my government will provide a monthly pension of rupees 1,500 to the physically handicapped. Special care towards the welfare of the poor, the meek and the weak. We will introduce a monthly pension of rupees 1,000 to the aged. Even destitute women would get a monthly pension of rupees 1,000. BD workers facing financial distress would be paid an allowance of rupees 1,000 per month. Housing is one of the basic needs of the people. We wish to take up dignified housing for the poor. Each unit would have 2 bedrooms, a hall and a kitchen with separate bath and toilet facilities, so that every family dwelling in them would live with self-respect and confidence. This model would be constructed at the cost of rupees 3 lakh per house. One of the thrust areas of my government is to modify the education systems on the lines of Professor Jaishankar's vision. My government is committed to provide compulsory and free education from KG to PG with CBSE syllabus in English medium to all the needy students. A welfare fund will be constituted with a corpus of rupees 10 crores for journalists whose role in achieving Telangana state was in. A corpus of rupees 100 crores would be set up for welfare of lawyers as they stood like a rock during the movement for the formation of Telangana state. Beneficiaries of the government's welfare measures include RTC workers, workers of Singareni collieries and workers involved in the construction sector. Auto rickshaws plying in Telangana state will be exempted from tax. Accident insurance will also be extended to them as well as workers in construction sector. A large number of youth who had migrated to the Middle East and North Africa are facing problems. Hence, my government will set up a special wing to address the problems of such non-resident Indians. We will draw up special plans to ensure the welfare of the workers in the Gulf region as well as their rehabilitation. My government will extend a special Telangana increment to all the government employees along with health cards to them. Let me make it clear that we would like to have an employee-friendly governance. I am confident that this would motivate employees to be public-friendly to rebuild Telangana. Women constitute about 50% of our population. History proved that they could excel in any area provided an opportunity is given. From farming to, we have the latest example of the village girl Malavat Purna of Nizamabad district, who has successfully planted the nation's flag on Mount Everest. Despite being the bedrock of the institution of family, some of them have become victims of social evils such as child marriage, dowry harassment, domestic violence, acid attacks and so on. No country can prosper unless women power is harnessed. Therefore, we are charting an elaborate program for the welfare of women. Strict enforcement of laws regarding women's safety and security particularly protection of women from domestic violence will be monitored. Keeping in mind the large number of women employees working in Hyderabad city, particularly in the IT sector, special focus on tight security and maintenance of law and order will be the priority of my government. We will work hard to make Hyderabad a safe haven for working women round the clock. In other words, our endeavor is to capacitate them and encourage them to play an effective role in all aspects of nation building. As majority of the population is dependent on agriculture and allied sectors for their livelihood, my government is determined to pay utmost attention to the rapid progress of agriculture, irrigation and power sectors, which are the principal debt burden, and to bring fresh hope and vigor. A waiver of crop loan up to rupees 1 lakh to each farmer will be implemented. Also, tax exemption will be provided to agriculture tractors and trolleys. Areas of agrarian stress will be identified where farmers are distressed, and teams will be sent for appropriate counseling. In order to support this sector with path-breaking research and development, and the agriculture department officials will actively conduct soil tests, and the status of soil test data will be tabulated and maintained mandal-wise. On the basis of this scientific data, a macro plan will be formulated in order to develop Telangana into specific crop colonies. To support and encourage farmers, input subsidy will be provided at every step, starting from seed supply, fertilizers and the use of farm mechanization. And agriculture scientists have found the agroclimate of Telangana best suited for producing high quality seeds. Steps will be taken to encourage farmers to produce seeds of high quality.